Alrighty, so today I'm going to be doing another Tiger version camo. This is going to be Tiger V4. These are pretty cool. I just picked these up at the dollar store. They're like gloves, so they're pretty sick. And so I'm going to be trying to recreate them. So today was a real treat. My sister got done doing a project, so she had poster board left over. So I'm going to be cutting on that today. So I'm going to just start talking away. Alrighty. So today I have three colors on this one, and as you can see, Woodland really only has three. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and reuse, if I can find it, this. So I'm going to have a wavy one, which I'm going to redo. I'm going to redo this stencil right here, and then I'm going to go with something like that for the black, and we're gonna see what we come up with. See if we can come up with anything really cool. So right now I'm just gonna try and isolate all these little different pictures. So the brown sort of looks like it's like sort of like my other one, but it has pointed edges. It's sort of like a hollow leaf. So it's gonna be something like that. You can add some other little pictures like that. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make them more elongated. So you just want to start off with nice smooth lines. And yeah. Alrighty, so now as you can see, I'm probably going to go over this in a darker color so I can really see what I'm doing. And I've sort of just copied that. It helps to really have what you're trying to do in front of you so you can really get a good idea. As you can see, I messed up right there. I should probably go back and redo this shape. What you're going to do right now? You may not want to make them blocky, because this one is really spreading everything out. And you really don't want short, jagged edges, something like that. You don't want anything like that. You want them more long and spread out, because the first coat is just trying to get the main picture across of what you're trying to do. And then when you go back and you black one, you can re-go and, you know, do whatever we want to do. So, let's go and redraw this one really quick. Alright, so now the next step's to cut it out.
Alrighty, so I've cut it out, and that's pretty much what it looks like right now. And just remember that when you're drawing it, when you're cutting it out, you don't actually have to do what you drew. So, it's just all if you want to improvise something, you can go ahead and do that. And remember the first layer, just try and always connect everything, like these two pieces right here are sort of connected by that one. And, so what I'm probably going to do is I'm going to probably extend this a little lower. So, yeah, and then of course that one and that one is connected by that one, so you sort of like, see it fits in. Just always just want to like puzzle it all together. So yeah. Alright, so now onto the smaller section. Now as you can see on that, it's sort of following the border of the first stencil. So what I'm going to try and do is I'm going to go grab some spray paint, and I'm just going to put these two on top of each other, and I am going to spray down pink. And why pink, you may ask? Well, it's pretty bright and the pencil's darker than that, so yeah. Alright, so that's what it looks like. Now I have a fresh piece of paper to cut along. So now I'm going to go and draw on that one, and I'll cut that one out. Alright, have fun.